the 12 tribes. We gonna jump it off. All praises, brother. We gonna jump it off with John 8, number 2. We gotta know the truth. We know the truth. This is the truth we're in. So let me get that John 8, 2, all right?
Hey, John 8, verse 32.
Bring it out, all right?
John chapter 8 and verse 32.
Bring it out.
And ye shall know the truth.
And ye shall what? Know what?
And ye shall know the truth.
Keep reading that.
And the truth shall make you free.
See, that's what's going on. Y'all have seen the laws passed by 15, 20 laws. They come up and talk to us. They gonna talk to us that shit that's off.
Whatever, take your ass home, dude.
Yo, we know where you're going, sister. You know what I'm saying? But we know the truth, y'all. We know that this country is full of lies. We know that we have been deceived by our enemies. That the white man has deceived us for years, many generations. But we have to come back to our laws. This is the truth. We know the truth is the law. We know the truth of these statutes and commandments for our house of Israel. It's not for everybody.
That's right.
You know, a lot of people don't understand that we like to share our God. It's time to start being possessive. The Bible is possessive. So why are we not holding on to our God the way these other people are holding on to their God?
That's right.
Many things are God. If you love that car more than you love the Lord, that's a God to you.
That's right.
That's right.
We are not supposed to be in love with other gods. Let me get Deuteronomy 32 and 31, 21. Hey, try
to
get
Deuteronomy.
Let's get it started. Bring it out, Hop.
The book of
What's up, brothers? How y'all doing, man? Can I get 5 minutes, 4 minutes, 2 minutes of your time, man? It ain't even a time for me.
Brother?
It's for the Most High. It's for the Most High, man. You know what I'm saying? The Most High. How you doing? If I ask y'all, brother, what's your last name, bro? What y'all tell me? I don't want to know too much detail. My last name, right? What's your last name, brother? What's your last name, brother? You a slave, you a slave, I'm a slave. We do not know who we are. Give me that scripture out there.
Okay,
shut up. We do not know who we are. That's the reason.
We
know who
that's
we are.
Right.
We don't know who we are.
Know.
After you come up here right now, what's his last name going
to be? I know.
It's going to be something like...
Wakanda.
Wakanda. Wakanda, something. If an agent come up here, what's like his that. Last name going
to
be? Hong Kong Koo. Chukong Young. But y'all and us... We got white folk last name. We are still slaves. We are still part of their possession.
Right now,
that's right.
The book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 1, verse 3. The ox knoweth his owner.
Now the ox is a stupid animal. Big ass, excuse me, big cow. You know what that is. You know what the ox is. The ox know his owner.
And the ass, his master's crib.
If you go take the ass from our deal, and you go take him to live better, that ass gonna still come back to our deal.
That's right.
And he dumb. That's a dumb animal too.
Right
but
down.
Keep going now.
But Israel.
But who?
But Israel.
You know y'all part of Israel too. I'm gonna get
that's
to that
right.
later. But Israel do not know. Keep reading now.
But Israel doeth not know.
And what else do our people do?
My people. Not consider.
We don't even care. We don't even seem to go back and think, bro, what happened before we got here. To think, why is the African last name an African last name? Why is the Chinese last name a Chinese last name, but I got this white man last name? We don't even consider it, man.
That's right, bro.
We got it.
Because
we was the chosen one.
Because
we
wanted
to
chosen
one.
That's right.
Right.
That's right.
Yeah.
Bring that out,
huh?
Deuteronomy. Right. We still the chosen. And he calling us out of this slumber. He calling us out of this slumber, sis.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verse 6.
Bring it out.
For thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God.
Here
in
the Bible, we are holy people. Holy in the Bible means separate.
That's right.
Now, see, we got to break down the Bible for our people because we don't know. We lost.
We have to come together.
We gotta
get that's a willingness and Stockholm syndrome.
That we are the chosen children.
Right. We have to come back as a people instead of living in each other.
The next
you know, mainly
what
they
gotta
get
do.
Burned.
Keep reading that out. You got
Titan.
Okay, well,
yeah.
You got Titan.
Right. Man, we just got a lot of people to
tell you
to keep, man.
For thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God.
A holy, that's
the Lord thy God have chosen thee.
Stop, the Lord thy God. You see how this
and
is
I'm like, hell nah.
What if we just said the Lord God? It said the Lord thy God. We keep letting all these other nations piggyback on our Lord.
That's right.
Who is that? That's what the Bible says that our Lord looks like.
That's right.
That's not exactly that picture, but it's a compare and contrast.
That's right.
To the other picture that doggy streaking her white guy.
That's right.
That they put up on it.
That's right.
We have to come back, man, and know what's going on, y'all.
Bring it out.
You know what I'm saying, man? Our spirit spectrum with y'all is this, too.
That's right.
The Most High made y'all gonna come this way.
That's right.
At this point in time.
That's right.
The prophets don't never be out here doing it. The prophets do the same.
That's right.
The prophets
bring it out, huh?
Let me get that.
The Lord thy God have chosen thee.
And chosen this guy.
To be
chosen this guy.
To be a special people.
Hold on, special? The Lord said I'm special.
What else he said, bro?
A special people to himself.
To himself. He said that possession that his Bible is not for everybody, it's for us. It's for the 12 tribes of
Israel.
That's right. It's us. Keep going.
Above all people.
Nah. Martin Luther King said we equal to him.
Above all people.
Nah, man, that white man that is above us. He killing us in this world right now.
Above all people.
Nah, the Chinese, big got Chinese shops over here, man. Big food over here.
Above all people.
What else?
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Upon the face of the earth, man. He ain't say above around the corner. In North Dallas, but not in Oklahoma. In Pennsylvania, but not in Florida. He said upon the face of the earth.
That's right.
So that means from here to there, we are the chosen people.
That's right.
But the white man want to keep you down.
That's
wanna
right.
Keep you killing each other.
That's right.
Want to keep you worried about a car. Or worried about some 28s. Or worried about some joy. Instead of worried about your nation, man.
Hey,
okay. Yeah, we talking about wicked Martin Luther King. A lot of people say he crazy. He don't like Martin Luther King? No. Martin Luther King messed us up. Bring it out.
You see, I have a dream. I have a dream. Said hey. The Bible.
Exactly.
But come on, man.
You need to go over
the Bible, man. Come on, man.
You need to go over the
Bible, man.
Bring it out.
You ain't know, man.
Deuteronomy,
chapter 13, verse 1.
Bring it out.
If there arise among you a prophet or a dreamer of dreams, and giveth thee a sign or a wonder.
I'm going to drop down. And the sign or wonder come to pass, whereof he spake unto thee, saying, let us go after other gods which thou hast not known, and let us serve them. Thou shalt not hearken unto the words of that prophet or the dream of dreams. For the Lord your God proveth you to know whether ye love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul.
Right.
Ye shall walk after the Lord your God and fear him, and keep his commandments, and obey his voice, and ye shall serve him and cleave unto him.
That's right.
And
right.
That prophet, or that dreamer of dreams, shall be put to death, because he has spoken to turn you away from the Lord your God.
That's right.
Now, how many times did you hear your God? I know I heard it 4 or 5 times in that one scripture. How many times did you hear dreamer of monster dreams?
He's
a repetitious, man. This Bible is repetitious.
That's
you
still right.
Got to open it up and read it.
That's it.
Martin Luther King hindered us.
That's right.
He put us equal to these white folks.
That's
but
right.
We above their ass.
That's right. Right.
That's right.
He got over us.
That's right.
But we act like it. Why? Because we're over here. Arms in a bucket. He another black man with a nice coat. We hate on him instead of congratulating that brother.
That's right.
But then that brother ain't helping his people because he done stepped on so many of our other people.
That's right.
Come on, man. You get any black person in a good situation 9 times out of 10, they step on so many other people to get to where they're going. That's why they'll never come back. Bring that scripture out.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 2, verse 14.
Bring it out.
Is Israel a servant?
That's what the prophet answered Most High. It's the nation of Israel only a servant? Because that's all we've been doing. We went into 7 captivities.
That's right.
7. Everything we do, y'all, is from a captivity that we was in.
That's right.
Basketball, we're not supposed to do that.
That's right.
But guess what? With that Greek
captain, come on up here, brother.
The Greeks, you know, they was into that sports and,
that's right.
and throwing our people out there to the line. You know what I'm saying? That was one of our captivities we got sports from. You know what I'm saying? Everything that we're doing in this world is of somebody else's nation.
That's right.
So we have to
that's
come
right.
back to our own heritage
that's right. That's
and
right.
get back to these laws they got us out of. They
bring
got us
out,
out
y'all.
Of the
Most High. Y'all.
Bring it out, y'all. What you got?
I got you. The book of Ezekiel, chapter 22 and verse 26.
Bring your scriptures out.
Her priests have violated my law.
Priests. Now who you think they're talking about? They're talking about a lot of these pastors up here telling us that, oh yeah, put your little money in the plate. Come as you are. You gay? That's cool. Come on in here and give me your money. What that sound like? A business, man. That's a hustle. People going out.
And have profaned mine holy things.
The word holy means his separate things. They have profaned his separate things, the things he put apart and told them not to mess with like us. They have messed with people.
They have put no difference between the holy
and profane.
The clean and the unclean.
Neither have they shoes different between the unclean and the clean. And have hid their eyes from my Sabbath. And I am profane among them.
That's right.
That's what the Sabbath is. That's the Sabbath, you know what the Lord calls the Sabbath? That's the day of the holy day that he kept set. Today is the Sabbath.
Right.
Friday night to Saturday night is the Sabbath. But what the white man got us doing? Going to church on Sunday, right? We're out of order with the Most High. That's what people don't understand.
Break it out, right?
As long as they can control us, we will never get back. The Most High gonna never crack that
stuff. Break it out,
man. We are gods. Give me that, bro. You are gods, man. God done, it's going down, man. And I need some young brothers up here with us to tell these people to come back, man. See these laws, that's the commandment. Bring that out.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 10 and verse 21.
Bring it out.
Ye cannot drink of the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils.
Here it is. You can't be up there going to the weed house and then going to church Sunday, come back. You do with the Lord. Yeah. You can't do both. Yeah. You gotta draw a line. What side are you on? Huh? Are you on the righteous side or are you on the other side of the wicked?
Break it out.
You got two sides, man.
Break it out.
It's time to grow up, y'all.
Break it out, man.
Stop being kids and they grow up.
Break it up.
You know what I'm saying? This world is going down. Yes, and if you want to go down with it, you stay on this side.
That's right.
Focus on this side.
Break it out.
Bring it out, Ock.
Ye cannot be partakers of the Lord's table and of the table of devils.
Same thing. You can't go. You can't go sit up with your pockets kicking in the hood and then try to come out here and tell these people to wake up, man. It's just not possible. You can't do it. You cannot have that going on. What you got? You got some holding? You holding some for me? Straighten it out, man. Yeah, man, look. Spirit flexing with y'all. Y'all heard. Y'all listening. Everybody else doing up here. Come on. I got to go. I got to be y'all listening, man. Y'all need to check it out. Bring it out.
The book of Psalms, chapter 82, verse 6.
Bring it out.
I have said, ye are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High.
That's right.
And that Bible just told me that he said, Most High said that we are gods. Woo. Come on, man. Do you believe we are God? We are God. Do you believe that we can have God-like powers? But hold on,
right.
Check this out.
Right.
Keep listening to the scripture.
Right.
Yeah. And I'm gonna break it down for you. You're absolutely right.
But ye shall die like men. And fall like one of the princes.
But he said that we gods. Do we act like we gods on this world? But that's because we gonna die like these men, because we're not coming back to his laws, statutes, and commandments. But if we come back to these laws, y'all, we get powers, man. Immortal. Would you trade in 20, 30 years on this world of success for everlasting life? We're not worried about this world. These guys up here, we ready to go. You know how people say you ready to die? We ready.
God.
That's right.
We know where we're going.
God.
Let's ask him a question.
All right, bro.
We got that only God can judge thing hat on, right? Yeah. We're going to do some judging.
That's right.
This place is wicked as hell, man.
That's right.
Like we brought out the scripture earlier. Who worship and serve the creature more than the creator?
Man.
Everything in this world is made of the man.
That's right.
The Lord say, don't love this world. Any man that loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him.
That's right.
We got to be on a deeper level. We ain't talking about this fleshy stuff. We talking about your soul. We talking about after somebody dies, what happens after that.
That's right.
This book tells you that. But these people will never understand your mission. You have to choose what God told you to do. So we're going to be judged, but we're going to be judged on what we did according to the law. Like when you go to court, don't you get judged on the law if you broke the law or not? Say, I give me this right here. Right here. I'm going to give it back to you. Give me that Sirach 17:11. This is what the people don't understand about this book, man.
The book of Ecclesiasticus in the Apocrypha, chapter 17, verse 11. Besides this, he gave them knowledge.
He gave them what?
Knowledge.
Read.
And the law of life for inheritance.
This is the thing, bro. This is the laws, the book of the law. Give me 4:4:1. This is our knowledge. This is the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans' knowledge, because we don't know who we are, right? This book tells us who we are. This is not no white man book, bro. We would not be on this corner. On fours and off the, I used to hustle on this book. I would not be back here with the Bible if it wasn't 150% proof that this book is talking about us. Factual, bro. be just like you. We all come from the same cloth. We all come from the same place. And I'm telling you, you can look me in my eyes, bro. I'm dead serious. Pull that scripture. While we out here killing each other and serving dope to each other and doing this stuff to each other, it's because we don't know who we are.
That's right.
They gave us this garbage right here. We just had a Mexican up there.
They say
this Jesus, right? But the scriptures say this is what Jesus looked like. They give us the cross. They give us Sunday morning worship. And say, that's the truth. That's a lie, bro. Our people don't read the book. That's the key. Hey, you heard the proverb? If you want to hide something from a nigga, do what?
Put it in a book.
It's truth. But we talk to many hundreds of people. But you would think it was still against the law for a Negro to weed.
Right.
Somebody give me when I was a slave, Bob.
Right there.
Give me that. Man, I want them to give. You give what you get. But we out here because this is the facts. This is our knowledge. This is our heritage. The word that he used was heritage.
That's right.
Right? That's the thing. This is the Israelites' heritage. Moses was an Israelite from the tribe of Levi.
That's right.
Christ was a Levite, an Israelite from the tribe of Judah.
That's right.
All the disciples was Israelites. John the Baptist, everybody in his book, when they don't tell you those prophets in the Old Testament, the disciples in the New Testament, are Hebrew Israelites.
That's right.
They're not just Jews.
Now come on over to man, U-turn.
That's a blanket statement that they throw in there. It's deeper than that. Jew comes from the word Judah.
That's right.
That's where they get the word Jew from, and the Romans called us Jews when we lived in Judea. Now those white folks just took that and said, oh, we the Jews.
That's right.
And
that's
they don't say they the Israelites. Give me, what you got for
me? I had that, you just said told him right there, what you
want.
Now, he just told y'all we the same king. Yeah. Titus 3, chapter 3. For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish, disobedient, deceived, serving diverse lusts and pleasures, living in malice and envy, hateful, and hating one another.
That was us, too. That was us. What is a real nigga? But all of that right there. A real nigga ain't finna let no nigga get over on him on no money.
That's right.
He can be your brother. Nah, nigga, you owe me my money. I need my skrilla, bro.
Huh.
That's a real nigga.
Huh.
A real brother gonna be like, I loaned you the money, bro. You good.
Bring it out.
I'm not even gonna give you. If it's a loan, it's a loan. That real brother gonna pay you back.
I gave it to you because you need it.
Exactly. If I'm giving it to you, I'm giving it to you. A real nigga, no, I need all of my money.
Huh.
That's what all they teach us in the movie.
Huh.
Money, money, money. So therefore, we have questions on all people for the money.
Sure.
But the money is useless, bro. You only can buy something to eat. Something that's useless, so you can buy a nice car, spend all your money up on that. But what you gonna do when you're 65 and you spent all this money up on these whips and all this? See, Negroes don't think about that. I know, because I work with people that was over 65 and they talk about my medication so high I might as well die. Because you ain't thinking about the future. You know what I'm saying? We thinking about the future because we thinking about our spirit. I need you to get a Bible right quick. Because I need these brothers, Leviticus 19 and 17. This is what we're doing right now, bro. If we kept this one commandment, we would do away with black on black crime. That's a fact, and that's what we trying to do. Because we wasn't foolish too. I said I was fooling niggas. But then I came into the truth and the Lord put me with God's spirit, bro. These still the same hard-hitting brothers.
Right, right.
These still the same hard brothers that was in the streets. But their direction and their focus is positive now. Read that.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 7. And if it be eaten, 19 and 17, thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
We are not supposed to hate each other in our heart. When we see you brothers, we look as brothers, man. I don't see niggas. I don't see a nigga from another hood or a nigga from a gang or a nigga from another side of town. I'm telling you the truth. I see brothers. If you came and rolled with us today, we going to treat you like our brothers. Because I got brothers. We got brothers that we can't even treat like we supposed to treat. Because your niggas so wicked.
That's right. What's up, young brother?
So therefore, your brothers is the one that do the will of the Father.
That's right.
Christ didn't even claim his own mother and his brothers because they was in wickedness.
Yeah.
He claimed the disciples and said, these my mother and my brother.
That's my brother.
Because we on the same accord. Pull that out. That's the key to it. We on the same mind frame, bro. And it starts with the black Messiah, knowing who you are, and keeping the laws, statutes, and commandments of God. And that way you will feel the brotherhood that you're supposed to feel. Finish that.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart. Thou shalt not in any wise shall
I.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
Now this is a stumbling block right here. When we come out of here, you heard what it said. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor. Rebuke means to correct.
That's right.
So the reason why you're going to do that is because you care for your brother.
That's
like
right.
If your little brother was out doing some stupid shit, ain't you going to try to talk to him?
Right.
That's what we try to do. We
That's
see
right.
our brothers out here doing stupid stuff. We was doing the stupid stuff too.
That's it.
And we like, bro, we telling you that ain't the way to go. First
That's
and foremost, because we done been there, done that, but look at all the brothers that's locked up.
Right.
Look at all the brothers that's dead. The way to go is to fear your God and not this bastard right here.
No.
We don't fear homosexuals.
That's right.
We don't fear Sanchez Borgia. We know who this guy is.
We know.
They hid him from us, but we know who he is.
Huh.
They got a whole series on the family of this guy.
Huh.
His name is Cesar Borgia. They got the Borgia family series. So we know about this guy. This is not no God right here, man. This guy ain't here. And what white man ever sacrificed himself for anybody?
And they even apologized for putting us in slavery? Hell
no.
One man, white man, even came on TV or anything. They said that when they so-called freed us in 1800, they said it was 40 acres in the middle. And y'all family got 40 acres in the middle.
But you know who got something? Those fake Jews who pretended to be you got our land.
They lied about.
They used to have the Balfour Declaration. Look it up.
Bring it up.
The Balfour Declaration.
That's right.
They already had it in place with Britain before World War II that they was going to get that land.
Before 1846 when they was implicated into that land.
1846. So we know what we're talking about, bro.
We know what
we're talking
about.
You got people that's committing identity theft right now on y'all. On us. Not just y'all on us. We taking it back. Exactly. Get that scripture out. What you got,
folks? Nah, Proverbs, by word.
Oh, yeah.
Deuteronomy.
Look at this. Look how raw your Christ is.
28:37.
The book of Matthew, 12 and verse 46.
Read!
Bring it out! Ye yet talk with the people. Behold, his mother and his brothers stood without, desiring to speak with him. So Mary, who they raised up as a god in the Catholic Church, which is bullshit,
That's not of God. First of all, we don't worship no women.
God.
We ain't disrespecting our mother Mary, but we don't worship women. They God. Worship women because they of the goddamn devil, and you can look up the Catholic Church.
Mm. God.
They worship Lucifer. Oh, we don't do none of that.
Hey.
Then one said unto him, behold, thy mother and thy brother stand without, desiring to speak with thee.
Read.
But he answered and said unto him that told him, who is my mother? And who are my brethren?
Read.
And he stretched forth his hand toward his disciples. And he said, behold, my mother and my brethren. For whosoever shall do the will of my Father,
man,
that which is in heaven, the same shall be my brother and sister and mother.
What?
My brother's right here.
All right.
And if you came into his truth, you will see. You got something for me? All right, bring it out. You will see that this is real, bro. Your own family will tell on you because you're going to tell them the truth, and they don't want to hear the truth.
That's right.
They want to worship the white man, especially the black woman. I know y'all been seeing them interracial commercials on TV, huh? A lot of white men with black women, huh? Every time I turn around, I watch TV on another country, and they got the same shit going on. But then, just in the 60s, they was against blacks and whites being together. But now, all of a sudden, he's just pushing it hard. But why they ain't pushing the black man now that we supposed to be with him in the first place? But why they ain't pushing the black man with the white woman? Because the white man wants his woman, and he wants your woman too. And he wants the Chinese man woman, and the Mexican woman. He wants everybody woman, but he don't want us to have nothing.
That's
so he took our land, took our nationality, took our heritage, taking our women, took our life. The only thing they ain't took was our soul. And we ain't giving that up. You got that? Read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 37.
Read.
And thou shalt not become an astonishment.
Read.
A proverb and a byword.
We gonna be an astonishment. When these foreigners come over to this country, they be like, look at them niggas. They was born in America. What's wrong with them? Well, damn it, we didn't get a 7-year tax break.
Right.
That's right. Damn it, we didn't get the 40 acres
in the middle
you supposed to gave us.
Right.
We just, like when they let us out of slavery in 1865. Oh, you niggas was free.
now?
Where we going? Right. Paul, we ain't got no money. You done hyped everything up on us. You give us a little farm, and then you overcharging us for that.
That's right.
Then they start Jim Crow. Then they get the Ku Klux Klan. And these guys just want to sit there and look at us like we're an astonishment. But you don't want to know why. Because they all against us.
That's right.
They all against us. That's why. Why ain't no black people own no corner stores? But we the main ones going in the corner store. Why we don't know? This the only black restaurant I know of here. All the rest of them is foreigners. If you go to Pleasant Grove, go to Oak Cliff, go to South Dallas. Majority niggas and Mexicans.
Yeah.
Why we don't own nothing? That's we gotta go in and deal with our bead.
That's
and cuss his ass out. Over 7 cents. They don't want to let us make it on nothing. They already called the police on us as soon as we got here.
That's right.
We hadn't had an altercation. Wanna know why? Because they don't want y'all to know who y'all are.
Exactly.
Bro. It's a conspiracy. It's a conspiracy. I'm not bullshit. I'm not bullshit. Free. You got that? That's what we are here, bro. We in the broad daylight. We ain't got to hide in no church. The truth don't have to hide. Christ didn't hide in no church. Where did Christ go? To the highways and byways. He went to the people. The disciples went to the people.
If you see our shirt,
disciples of Christ, we coming to you. You ain't got to come to us. Read out.
The book of Psalms, chapter 83 and verse 1.
Read.
Keep not thy silence, O God.
Read.
Hold not thy peace. Be not still, O God, for lo, thine enemies have made a tumult.
Thine who?
Thine enemies make a tumult.
Y'all know y'all got enemies?
Yes.
Read.
You got enemies. Even they threw them around the 28. And they that hate thee have lifted up the head.
Y'all know people hate y'all, right? They gonna come up, and like, who think they after? Anybody think they after? Because we accept that to shreds. Because we living, there ain't nothing but Africans over here. Exactly,
God.
Father.
God.
And that's proven 2-3 times in Genesis alone. Joseph went to Africa. Abraham went to Africa. Moses, they thought he was an Egyptian.
Yeah,
they thought he went to Africa. They thought Paul was to Africa.
They thought
it was
the chosen one. Even Africa was
enslaved. Exactly,
God.
Bro.
God.
So we over here in America. It's every nationality of East Africans over here. Of
that's
West Africans over here.
They
do they claim us? We living in the same area. They got the orgasm looking at us like we shit. While we looking at them like they shit. And you smell like shit. Come on, sir. Don't look at me like I ain't shit. You ain't shit. Because if you was something, you wouldn't have to leave your country. If we had a country, I wouldn't never leave it to come to this wicked ass place, man. That's right. This place is wicked. And they done drunk, got everybody drunk off the wine of the abominations of the Catholic Church. Everybody loves this garbage. You got small on that. Read that, huh?
Read it. I appreciate it.
You definitely got to be.
They that hate thee, verse 3. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
They did what?
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
Let me ask you. Y'all, the UN. Who is our representation in the UN? Yeah. Black people. Who is we a separate nation from everybody else? Who is our representation? The white man? The white man representing us. The same bastard that put us in slavery representing us with the world. And then got the nerve to talk about humanitarian crisis in other countries. It's a humanitarian crisis over here for 400 years.
That's right.
These people is nuts. Read up.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden one.
That's what they doing right now. We go in that store, don't we? Who in there? Africans, right? You go in that store, it's Arabs over there, right? You go over there, it's Africans and Arabs. And everywhere you go, it's Africans and Arabs and Chinese and all this. That's big crafty counsel. How is it that every city, in every black Hispanic neighborhood, the Arabs and the Chinese own everything?
Verse 4, they have said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation.
That's what they say?
Come, let us cut them off from being a nation.
So when we read Isaiah 1 and 3 and it say the ox knows his owner, the ass is master crib, but Israel don't know who they are. Neither do they consider. Because they say what?
They have said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation. That the name of Israel.
The name of who?
Israel.
The name of the African American?
Israel.
The name of the blacks?
Israel.
The name of the Negro?
Israel.
The name of the Mexicans?
Israel.
The name of the Indians?
Israel.
The name of the Haitians?
Israel.
The name of the Jamaicans?
Israel.
The Cubans?
Israel.
that's one of them names that means
real,
something.
Man.
And it don't mean nothing that makes sense.
It's real.
Jamaica, the land of wood and water.
Huh?
Puerto Rico, the Puerto Ricans.
Huh?
What the hell is that? African American, two white men.
Mexico,
come on, man, read.
But they have consulted him with one consent.
They did what in the UN?
But they have consulted with one consent.
What did the British and Americans do?
But they have consulted together with one consent.
What did the Spanish and the Portuguese do?
But they have consulted together with one consent.
What did the Edomites do?
But they have consulted together with one consent.
Let me make it clear one more time. What did the white folks do?
But they have consulted together with one consent.
Who?
They are confederate against
Hold on, wait a minute. They what?
They are confederate against thee.
Where do we hear that word at, bro?
In the South.
Who is the bastards that want to keep us in slavery, bro?
The white.
And what did they call themselves and want to run?
Confederate.
And we want to fall their what?
Confederate.
At what?
Confederate.
Man, our people better wake up, man.
Read
up.
The tabernacles of Edom.
The white man, where that sign at? Show them. Hey, Bobby, where the sign with all the nations on?
The 17 to 18 nations. Right there. Look right there.
Right here.
We got all the nations in the Bible in here.
The tabernacles of Edom.
The white man.
And the Ishmaelites.
The Arabs.
Of Moab.
The Chinese.
The Hagarenes.
The Egyptians.
The Baal. And Ammonon.
What was that?
Ammonon.
Oh, that's the Japanese.
Amalek.
The fake Jew.
Philistine.
Africans.
And the inhabitants of Tyre.
Africans. Who is the ones in our neighborhood?
That's your Lord, my boy.
The Amalek.
Started from the beginning again. Edom.
The tabernacles of Edom.
That's the white man.
And Israelite.
The Arab man.
Of Moab.
The Chinese man.
Agarim.
The African.
Gabal.
The African.
Ammonon.
The Japanese.
Amalek.
The fake Jew.
The Philistine.
Africans.
The inhabitants of Tyre.
And Africa. You want to know why it's more Africa? Because Africa is one of the biggest, ain't the biggest Africa?
Of course, and I
it's right there, brothers. It's right there, and it's live and direct. This book is not old. This book is living right now. That's why we right here right now. Because we read this book, we study this book, and it's not old.
Give me that.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15.
Hold on.
You already know.
Hey, you got blessed right there? Let me read one more scripture for you. Give me 22 and 14. Revelation. He's going to show you what being blessed is, bro.
Right.
Yeah. We on YouTube. That's your Lord and Savior, bro. Not this garbage right here. We ain't representing. We coming to tear this down, man. Let me show you what blessed is. Give me Psalms 1 and 1.
Last scripture, fellas. I appreciate y'all dialoguing with us, man.
22 and verse 14.
Read.
Blessed are they that do.
What up? Blessed are they that what?
That do.
That is commandment. That what?
That do. Is commandment.
Read.
That they may have right to the tree
to
of life.
And what up?
And may enter
to the,
through the gates and through the city.
You got to be keeping these commandments to get the new kingdom. The new kingdom is rulership, man. It ain't that pie in the sky that they sell. The white man is in heaven right now. He can go anywhere on this planet and do whatever he want to do. We're going to have that. Because that's what the new world going to be.
And the
new world is going to be a new government. This earth is going to be here. But the people ruling this earth is going to change. Just like in the dark ages, it was blacks ruling here. We're going to go back to that.
All right, well,
these people think they're going to live forever. Give me that right quick.
Psalms chapter 1 and verse 1.
Three.
Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel
of what?
The ungodly.
Blessed is the man that walked not in the counsel of the ungodly. So you can't be around your drug dealing partners and think you're going to be blessed. These people think you blessed me. Oh, the Lord gave me a car. He don't care about that, bro. He going to destroy all that shit.
That's right.
He care about you being obedient to what he asked us, told us to do.
That's right.
What we made a covenant, a contract with him to do.
Right.
See, this contract extends from Moses and the children of Israel all the way to us. Because it's in there. They not only made a contract
on their own. They made it for their children. So that's why we out here, brothers.
Y'all need to come over here and get this Bible in your life. All three of y'all.
A lot of people, they don't understand when they say I'm covered in blood. They don't understand. They don't understand. It's nasty. See, if it's already done, it's ancient thing. That's what's going on in the context.
You all right, man? You all right? Y'all can't speak to a father? Y'all like speaking to people? That's wrong with our people. We don't even like speaking to each other. We can't even say hi to each other.
When you got Christmas, sir.
This is the main point that we out here for. We trying to bring the brotherhood back together. Bring the brotherhood back together. Because if the men don't stand up, why it's like it is right now, why our women is out of control and wearing spandex and all that garbage, is because the men ain't strong.
Come on over here.